So my name is Shawn Douglas, and I'm an assistant professor at the University of California, San Francisco. We're in my office in Mission Bay, and I run a research lab here. And so we're trying to use nanotechnology with building blocks from our own living cells, like DNA and proteins, in order to build useful things to hopefully cure diseases.
Okay, hi, come on in.
Well, one thing that we're trying to address is how to build better chemotherapies or better cancer therapeutics. So there's a big challenge that every cancer patient, or many cancer patients, depending on what type of cancer they have to face these really nasty regimens of drugs. If we step back and think, okay, well, suppose we could design from scratch the ideal therapeutic, what properties would it have? Well, now that we have software, it takes hours, but back when we first started, it would take weeks or months sometimes to design something. And then you order all the DNA, which is hundreds, sometimes thousands of dollars, and you finally get all that DNA together in the lab and you mix it together and then anneal it under different conditions, purify that material, and then eventually take it to the electron microscope. And when you finally get this microscope in focus and you see hundreds of thousands of little particles, and you zoom in and you finally can make out, oh, actually the thing that I designed, it worked, it self-assembled, and there's, you know, thousands of copies of that little device, and that's like really, really cool. I could trace back my interest in building things back to just growing up working with my dad in the shop. So we had a little workshop in the backyard. And yeah, my father was always, well before I was born, building model airplanes, model cars, model rockets. You know, I just grew up tinkering and building, taking things apart. Maybe, well, when I was in fifth or sixth grade, I got my first computer, which was like a 386 SX with, you know, 2 megabytes of RAM and 100 megabyte hard drive. And then I got into more building my own computers. So that was my background. And then when I was in college, I didn't really have much direction starting out. My freshman year, I was majoring in English after I failed all my science classes. and then I kind of worked my way back to science by way of computer science. So yeah, when I got to grad school, then I just rotated in different labs and talked to different professors. And the things that really stood out to me were William Shi's lab. So he was a new assistant professor working in this field that almost nobody had ever heard of, DNA nanotechnology. And the idea there is actually, rather than using DNA as a genetic kind of information storage material, we would instead kind of repurpose it as like a Lego building block. This stuff just worked, and then it was just kind of no turning back. I was just addicted at that point. There's a lot of problems in the world that people who are not so fortunate, just because of bad luck, maybe they have some genetic disorder or have gotten sick for some reason that we don't yet understand. And after a while, you start thinking like, okay, well, we have this really powerful method of using DNA to make self-assembly nanostructures. And we can look at nature and see that nature uses self-assembly to do all sorts of really sophisticated things. So then it kind of raises the question, well, can we repurpose DNA to build devices that would actually do useful things just like our own immune system does? But since we're building them from scratch, then maybe we could actually design them to do even more than what already exists. So that's kind of the vision for the technology and for working in the lab that would actually justify kind of all the fun, cool stuff that we get to do in terms of Lego building block. It's actually very serious potential applications, even though the kind of process itself is actually could be really fun. Thank you.